Well, good morning, guys. We're finally out of Maryland. We're now in Virginia. And look at this view. Like, I've been awed by this view like all night and all morning so far. It is incredibly beautiful. I'm so happy I did this. Because last night, man, I was dreading it. I was so worried last night about not feeling happy during this. Because I drove 4 hours. And I think that's the longest time I've driven in one sitting. Four freaking hours to get all the way here. And I felt it myself. I was like, okay, I'm kind of feeling, why am I doing this? I should turn back. I should go back home. I should go back to 9 to 5. And that's crazy. Who wants to go back to 9 to 5? I don't. I'd rather be living out on the road in the middle of nowhere with my good old pup, exploring different locations, and just, I mean, all I see is mist right now, but seeing different views. Damn, look how high I am. Don't want to fall, but I'd rather be living this lifestyle than working a 9 to 5 every day. Just me. But enough chit chat. Let's hit the road. Come on, Roo. Load up. Let's go.
Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just watch the bandit run.
This is the entrance to a 4x4 trail. It's very tempting, but I don't have enough cameras to record a good enough video for you guys, so. Very tempting, but I can't do it. I gotta continue on my road. Damn. Next time.
Eastbound and down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way.
This place is $1.63 a gallon. Freaking crazy. Alright. See, how much did it cost for gas today? Watch out. Back home, it cost me about $60 to fill this tank. Today, it only costed me, well, you can't see it, oh well. It cost me $42. The difference it makes. Man, Virginia has so many things to offer. So beautiful here. I would live here, but I just hate the gas mileage of hills and everything. Oh, but look at this. It's called the Natural Bridge. You know, you gotta take Ruin a little walk. Might as well see a beautiful sight in the meantime. Man, it's beautiful. Well, Rue, I didn't plan on going into the water, but she fell in and got up, or she didn't fall in, she jumped in and then got scared and didn't want to come out, so I had to go get her and I freaking fell in. Thanks, Rue. Yeah, go play in the water. I still love her though. You turd. Now it's on to the next day for the two of us. Freaking wet dog right here. So, on to our next location. We're in North Carolina, I believe this is. We're going to the I think it's called the Leaning Rock. Well, it started pouring on me in South Carolina, so Tennessee, here I come. All right, Google Maps, you beat me. Beat me fair and square. I fell into it. Google Maps led me down this road, which I thought lead to a campsite, or at least to a dead end. And there is no road. This is where I came in. I had to turn around now, but. Dang Google Maps led me to a dead end. Freaking raining, slipping around all over the place. I mean, I could probably continue, but there's some downed trees up ahead. And it says there's a campsite right around the corner. But my baby might be a little too big for this. She might be a little too big. There's a big tree right there down. So, I doubt I'm gonna be heading forward anymore. But Google Maps, I'll give you props. Done did that to me. Well, let's hope I can get out of here. Cause, oh man, that hurt. This mud is really, really soft. So, I don't know. That's where she sits now. She has to be right there. That mark is, that's where she sits. And I mean, when I say wet, I mean this mud. Like, I put that rut there just through driving. So, let's hope I don't have to hike back to a house up there and get the guy out here to pull me out. Crossing my fingers. Well, this is probably a bad idea. I'm going to leave my camera out in the rain while I try to get this truck out. Let's see what I do. And yeah, before you say, oh, you can get out, I really can't. I can't back up anymore. My hitch is in the dirt and my bumper on the tree. Well, not right now, but it would have been. My axle is really like cattywomped. I don't want to show you. And look, this is all just for me. So the dirt was up here. Now it's all the way down here. So this dirt is just wet. And it's not a good combo for me right now. These are the first time these tires have failed me. This sucks. If I have to camp here tonight, that's really gonna suck. I have to walk all the way back. Oh man. Just cause this freaking trees. Should've just cut them down. You learn from your mistakes. Well, Goldie, I'll be back. Let's go, Rue.
Hello, how you doing?
Hey, pretty good, how are you?
My name's Cameron.
Yes.
I'm trying to get to a campsite, and I got stuck on that one road.
Uh-huh.
I was wondering if you or anybody else know, or knows anybody
to get,
that...
campsite.
Yeah.
I've got 2 4-wheel drives. Give me a second.
Alright, much appreciated. No problem, take your time.
This dude is super nice. He gave Rue some food. And he also gave myself some food. Dude, whoever you are, if I don't get your name by the end of the night, thank you, you're great. It sucks because we're on hills. I think he's just spinning out right now.
We're getting stuck, ladies and gentlemen. Both of us. Let me go see what's up with him. Alright, he's got a fort, so his locks weren't engaged. No, they are.
Yeah, I don't want you getting stuck. Now we gotta use the tractor. We're getting there. Got his truck halfway out. Watch out. The tractor definitely worked. I told him he should probably get that instead of the truck. He says he wanted to pull me out in comfort. Look where that got us. But I appreciate his help. 1,000 times. This is the worst part of this trip so far, but the best part. At the same time. Almost out. Rue just got thrown around.
Out. Wow, it's only 9
was at 928. I'm just now getting out of the woods. His truck is still back there because I'm gonna drive him back, but dude, you're a lifesaver.
Your turn.
My first off-road failure. Yay.